The apparatus consists of a reservoir with a V-notch weir, two atypical valves, a fixed speed pump, two digital pressure gauges, several manometers, three negative pressure manometers, and an air filtering box. Safety considerations. Closed-toed shoes and safety glasses must be worn while performing this experiment. Check that there is sufficient water in the reservoir. The water level upstream from the V-weir should be just touching the bottom of the V. The water level in the reservoir after the weir should be at most 1 foot below the upstream reservoir. If there is insufficient water in the reservoir, air will be sucked into the piping system and cause problems for the pump. Be sure to add water to the reservoir if the level is low. Use the green hose attached to the wall. Be sure to return the hose to the reel when you are finished. Do not leave it across the floor. Begin by recording the zero height of the weir. Turn on and zero the pressure gauges. Make sure that the inlet valve A to the pump is fully open. Make sure that the outlet valve B is closed. Turn on the pump. Slowly open the pump outlet valve B until the water level in manometer 1 reaches 132 inches. Be careful not to open the pump outlet valve fully or water will leak from the top of manometer 1. In order to get meaningful data from the manometers, a common reference height is needed. Use the center line of the bottom pipe. Make sure that there are no bubbles in the manometer tubes or your data will be incorrect. For the differential manometers, ensure that the bypass is closed before recording data and measure the height on both sides. Begin by recording the following data. The water height in the reservoir. This will give you the pipe inlet pressure. The manometer readings at points 1 and E. The values for the digital pressure gauges. Note that the digital gauges measure negative values in inches of mercury and positive gauge pressure in PSI. Remember that you will need to convert everything to a common system of units. Reduce the flow through the system by closing valve B. As a first step, close the valve until the water height in the manometer 1 drops by 10 to 15 inches. Record the flow rate by measuring the height of the water on the V-notch weir. Record the pressure at the pump inlet using the height of the water above the inlet pipe. Record pressure at both digital pressure gauges. Record the pressure at point 1 and E using the manometers. Remember that the pressure gauges read in inches of mercury for negative pressures. Once you are satisfied with your data, close valve B a little bit more and record all of the data again. Repeat this process until air enters the pipe system from the manometers. In this part of the experiment, you will observe what cavitation, or the entrainment of gas in a liquid system, looks like. Open valve B until the water level in manometer 1 reaches 132 inches. Slowly close valve A until you observe bubbles appear in the pipe after valve A. This is cavitation. Observe the effect of cavitation on flow rate and manometer readings. Once you have completed this step, open valve A slowly until it is fully open. Another way that the pump's performance can be affected is if the supply of fluid is choked off by some constriction in the piping system. To simulate this, we will use the baffle in the reservoir to restrict water flow to the pipe to entrain a vortex so it sucks air into the intake. Lift the baffle out of its slot and insert it diagonally across the reservoir outlet and manipulate it so as to restrict the outflow. Observe the effect on pump performance.